I've not seen but three lineal champs at the heavyweight division in my lifetime. The first one would be Iron Mike, the baddest man on the planet. The second one be Lennox Lewis, or excuse me, now it'd be Evander Holyfield. My bad, Evander, and your missing ear part. Lennox Lewis would be the third one, then Vladimir Klitschko. So, like, when Tyson Fury first beat up Vladimir Klitschko to take the belt, I was mad. Because I'm like, who is this dude off of Snatch coming in here to take the belts from a man, Vladimir, Dr. Steelhammer? One of the classiest dudes in the heavyweight division by what I thought was a clown, honestly. Still thought he was a clown when he went to fight Deontay Wilder. Then Deontay Wilder tried to give him that chin music, and dude did his Undertaker thing, and I'm like, oh, okay, that's why you're the gypsy bare-knuckle boxing champ. It ain't because you knock people out, it's because you can't be knocked out. And that's not the kind of person you want to get into a ring with. But apparently, that's not what Tom Schwartz thought. Tom Schwartz said, hey, I'm undefeated. I'm 24-0. I'll take on this dude, put all the belts on the line, and let's do this. And then you got Tyson Fury coming out here dressed like Apollo Creed in Rocky IV and not respecting the memory of Apollo Creed, because Apollo Creed died in that movie. But you know what? If you're Tyson Fury, apparently you live a charmed life, because you get to wear the same costume, come out here and get a second round knockout in style. I saw Tyson Fury do some things I've never seen him do before, with the ducking and the dodging and the weaving and just beating a really good fighter, by the way, bloody. Just smacked him. So now ESPN and Top Rank, who have the money behind Tyson Fury, talking about $100 million here, are making the distinction that they believe that Tyson Fury is the lineal champ because he beat the man. So what does the lineal champ mean? I really am trying to be educational in this aspect. When we talk about a lineal champ, what it means is the undisputed champ, the guy who had all the belts, was beaten. So you are the man who beat the man, and you become the lineal champ. And there's a lot of money in being the lineal champ, because it's claiming that you are a successor to the guys that I just mentioned, along with Muhammad Ali, along with George Foreman, Joe Frazier, Larry Holmes, Floyd Patterson, all the way back to my man Jack Johnson and your man John L. Sullivan, all right? But there's a problem with calling Tyson Fury the lineal champ, all right? There's a wilderness to this 30-year-old dude. Man, he's 30 years old. I'm 31. That's how old. Man, Tyson Fury's a baby. My goodness. But there's the problem with this. And the problem is, since he gave up one of his titles and was stripped of the other two after failed drug test, does that make him the lineal champ? Now, yes, I, as a person who knows, is intimate about struggles of depression, I get that. I understand. And the man fought back from that, and I give him all the respect in the world for that. But you still gave up the belts. And you can't give up the belts and still call yourself the lineal champ. Now, he'll say, I'm challenger to no man because I'm undefeated. And I do think he wasn't robbed of a draw. I think it was a draw because he got up off the mat against Wilder. And we're on a collision course for the best puncher in the heavyweight division, versus the best boxer in the heavyweight division. And it's been so long since I could actually say that there was a good boxer in the heavyweight division. That's something else I'm terribly excited about, because heavyweights are known for being able to knock each other senseless. We know this. Andy Ruiz did it to Anthony Joshua, and we all celebrated because the fat kid, you know, beat up the well-to-do, physically built bully. Cool. But because Andy Ruiz has those belts and Tyson Fury does not, can you really call that man a lineal champ? No, not with a straight face. I'm calling him a lineal champ because ESPN and Top Rank did it, and it's, you know, he on their network, on their television. But the more I get into it, the more I'm like, nah, man, you gave up the belts, and there are belts over there with Andy Ruiz, and you haven't consolidated all of them. Now, a lot of this is boxing's fault for having so many recognized heavyweight championship titles. But I can't fault Tyson Fury for doing much of anything other than winning. That's all the man has done. He's beat up everybody you put in front of him, and he looks like he could beat up almost anybody else. 6'9", 267 pounds. My man, Mayberry in here, Working Production, walks up in here. He says, hey, yo, what if that dude got ripped? Because, you know, he a little soggy. He a little soggy around the middle. He you know, got a keg on. And I'm going, you don't want that dude to be ripped, because then he's like 210 at 6'9", and you lose all the hand power that you have. You know, there's not as much coming behind those punches. But the way that he was moving around, maybe it's something for Tyson Fury to think about. Because as long as he wants to claim to be the lineal champ, I'm going to have an issue with it until he beats Andy Ruiz, takes belts, beats Deontay Wilder, takes belts. Patrick, I understand that boxing ain't necessarily your forte?
No. But it sounds like they're like Oprah. You know, you get a belt, and you get a belt, and you get a belt.
Ah.
No?
No, I don't think it's like Oprah.
Okay.
I do get where you're coming from, though, because we could say that's
kind of it. There's a lot of governing bodies. Is that the right word?
Well, there's lots of money in claiming to be the champ.
Hmm?
Okay?
Yeah.
I mean, think about the college football playoff. You got five power five conferences. You got five big conferences.
Yeah.
You got four spots.
Yeah.
You know, and you're always going to have somebody in that fifth spot claiming, no, we deserve this because we did this or that.
Yeah.
That's how I view it. Wherever there's money in claiming more than mm-hmm. one championship. There's money in saying to Kirby Smart saying in a 2A college football playoff selection committee, hey, we played Alabama close. They don't want to see us again. Like, really? For real? Mm-hmm. Like, if you're Deontay Wilder, you're going, that ain't the lineal champ because he ain't beat me. It's a draw. That's not a win.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm fascinated by the discussion around this.
Yeah.
Precisely because Tyson Fury came to Vegas for the first time, he's fighting over here for the first time.
Look, you again, and I'm not into the fight game, but UFC has grown and has become probably more popular than boxing. Again, I'm an outside
Says
observer. There's more coverage of it.
There's more coverage of it on ESPN.
Mm-hmm. But elsewhere, there's not. I mean, is boxing bigger on Fox? Is boxing bigger in other places?
Well, seeing as you got MMA on DAZN, you got Bellator,
mm-hmm.
right? But you got the UFC almost exclusively on ESPN and Fight Pass
yeah.
now. But we also got the fights out here locally. I see why you might say that.
Mm-hmm.
But as long as they're going to be guys like Tyson Fury.
Yeah. Well, that's where I was going is a guy like him seems like a guy who could get interest back.
Here's one. Is boxing more popular than Major League Baseball?
I would say no.
Why?
They have a bigger TV deal, I guess.
What,
they
right.
have a more...
Right.
It's more ubiquitous.
Right.
It's,
so the it's, way that we claim championships in sports is who's bringing in the most TV money.
Yeah.
So, okay. I mean, the NFL is looking at everybody going, it's cute y'all are talking about baseball and boxing.
It's interesting because you were talking last segment about streaming. You're right. The streaming is where content is going. I mean, ESPN at Plus and what they're doing.
More but to the point.
It's still.
Kyler Murray was asked this question. He said, okay. Hey, do you hear what they're saying about you on TV? It's like, I don't watch a lot of TV. I watch a lot of YouTube. Hey. Like,
okay.
That's 20-something
big.
Kid.
That's
yes.
big. So, again, the future. Right now, still today, the NFL, I think, was of the top 100 programs last year, the NFL was like 63 of them. So there's still power in over-the-air television right now. But, again, where's it heading? And for the Big 12, as I've been on this, too, because I find the business side of sports fascinating. Where, you know, obviously in boxing is on this, too. Like you said, this fight was on ESPN+. Plus. I'd assume this fight is on pay-per-view. It costs $39.99, and, well, I ain't going to pay for that. As someone who I'll pay for the big fights. If there's a big fight, I'll get the pay-per-view.
This was a big fight.
Mm-hmm. But yeah, you can get ESPN Plus for what, $4.99?
Monthly.
Yeah, $4.99 a month.
And they're doing like these promos like with UFC and stuff where you can buy ESPN Plus and the fight for basically $10 more on top of the $4.99 that you would have paid anyway.
Okay, so the fight still, you still pay extra to watch it.
But $10 versus $40.
Yeah. No, I see.
You know,
and the same
people who will pay pay-per-view prices for South Dakota versus Oklahoma telling me that they're not going to pay for this fight, I can't look at you with a straight face because it's like, what is important to you?
Mm-hmm.
And you'll say that this fight is not important to you. Well, it is important that you know who the heavyweight champ is in any division, in any sport. Like, do you know who the heavyweight champ is in the UFC?
UFC?
Yeah.
No.
That speaks to me about what the popularity is.
Mm-hmm.
Because we know that Tyson Fury is the heavyweight champ in boxing.
Yes.
But if we go out onto the street and we say, yo, do you know the difference between T.J. Dillashaw and Henry Cejudo?
No.
Right. You know what I'm saying? Like, you say Ronda Rousey.
I've heard of Ronda Rousey.
Right, right. So it's the personalities that are driving the sport.
Yeah. I think that's going to be true in any type of individual sport. If Muhammad Ali was dropped in the middle of boxing today, well, boxing would be pretty popular because Muhammad Ali was a charismatic figure.
I don't think so. I think he would be a lightning rod because he talked so much. And we're not in an age where people like to hear you talking about yourself. Think about Floyd Mayweather Jr. Best boxer of my lifetime. My favorite fighter ever. Horrible human being.
I've seen him fight. Yeah.
Right. But think about how he talks about himself.
Mm-hmm.
Most people, they can't stand him.
Yeah.
Same thing with Conor McGregor. Can't stand him.
Yeah.
And can't wait for him to make a mistake. know, but redemption stories.
I paid for the Mayweather McGregor fight.
Why?
I want to see it.
It was a spectacle. That wasn't.
It
a
is.
Fight.
It's a train wreck. It's the car wreck. It's the rubberneck theory.
Oh man,
I wanted to see it.
That we don't want to see people doing things at their best, and we just want to see the sideshow is upsetting to me, man. I can't with that. Like, I love to see precision.
Uh-huh.
I love to see people doing the best at the best, playing the best, and whatever it might be.
Well, isn't that Mayweather? I mean, isn't he a great tactical boxer
versus a dude that doesn't box?
Just a dude who just is a brawler.
Not even a brawler. He's from a different sport.
Just a punch.
MMA
thriller.
Is not boxing. Boxing is not MMA. Wrestling is not MMA. Is not boxing.
Mm-hmm.
You know, like, I don't want to see Jordan Burroughs fight Conor McGregor, even though I believe Jordan Burroughs is the best wrestler wrestling today. And I guess that's what I was kind of making the point about with Tyson Fury. It's like, cool, if lineal champ as a discussion gets people to talk about boxing in a very cool way, cool, call him the lineal champ. But if you talk to boxing aficionados about whether or not he's the lineal champ, they're going to look at you and be like, I don't think so, but that ain't his fault. And it ain't Anthony Davis's fault that, well, I'm about to take apart this trade in a way that probably ain't going to make him feel too great. But Anthony, just know that it's not personal, and I appreciate you listening to Sports Animal.